Hello friends, I'm CMA Ratna here. We are on the second part of the marginal costing. The first part was for both CMA first group and second group students. If you are a CA student, then you can also watch this video, and this is also equally important for you guys. And for the CMA students, this is for the second group, group 2 portion, this one. Right? Okay. In a factory, producing two kinds of articles, the limiting factor is the availability of labor. From the following information, show which of the product is more profitable. Okay, there are two products, product A and product B. Cost per unit is given, a material is given, and labor cost 3 rupees for product A and 1.5 rupees for the product B. And fixed overhead is also given, variable overhead is given, total cost is given, selling price is given, profit is given, total production for the month is given. So here the new word has come. What is that new word? The word is limiting factor. Limiting factor, first of all, you need to understand what is a limiting factor. Limiting factor in the sense, limiting factor are bottleneck resource are key factor. These three are same. When I'm saying limiting factor or bottleneck resource and key factor, means availability of the resources are very limited. You cannot expand this one. There is no possibility to expand this one. So this one we call it as a limiting factor. Then what we will do, we will try to produce the product which is giving more contribution for the limiting factor. Take the example, if I'm producing product A and product B, product A is giving per labor hour, example I am taking with the problem, we'll see, for labor hour it is contributing 5 rupees, and the other one is per labor hour it is contributing 6 rupees. Then obviously I will try to produce the product which is giving me more contribution for the limiting factor. So how to check what is the contribution for the limiting factor, we will see. But which one we will choose, in the sense, the when there is a limiting factor, we will choose the product which is giving the higher contribution for the limiting factor, not for the product per unit. Limiting factor, contribution for the labor hour. If the labor hours are limiting factor, then we will see the contribution for the labor hour. What is the contribution, like which product is giving the higher contribution for the labor hour, we will produce that product only. Right? Okay, we will see. Practically, this one. See how to check. One by one, we will see. There are two products, product A and product B. These are the independent situations it is given. There are two independent situations given. First one is product A, second one is product B. Anyhow, okay, I'll take the direct. Anyhow, you know what is the standard marginal costing. Sale price here is 14 rupees, here 11 rupees. From this, you will remove the variable portion. Material 5 rupees. Material 5 rupees. Next, labor for the product A 3 rupees. For the product B 1.5. Overheads divided into two parts. Fixed overhead is 50% of the labor cost, this much, and variable overhead is 1.5. So variable one, obviously we will write to the marginal cost 1.5, here also 1.5. So we will get the contribution 5 plus 3 plus 1.5 minus 14 is 4.5 is the contribution. What is this contribution? This is per unit. You need to understand here clearly, this is per unit. Why I am writing this also, I'll tell you. 5 plus 1.5 plus 1.5 minus 11 is 3 rupees. See, this is a contribution 3 rupees for the product B as per unit. But how many labor hours it has taken to produce the product A? for producing the product A, it requires 6 labor hours. So I will write here number of labor hours required. Number of hours required, this one, 6 hours, 3 hours. It means, I said here, come this side. We will produce the product which is giving more contribution for the bottleneck resource or the limiting factor. So, limiting factor here is the labor hour. So, contribution for the limiting factor, for limiting factor, that is a labor hour. So I am getting 4.5 rupees as a contribution for working 6 hours. Here I am getting 3 rupees contribution for working 3 hours. Obviously I will choose the one which is giving me more contribution for the labor hour or the bottleneck resource. So here 4.5 divided by 6 is 0.75 paisa per labor hour. 3 divided by 3, that is 1 rupee per labor hour. Right? So, by seeing this, what you need to understand, the product B is giving more contribution for the labor hour. So, we will try to produce the product B. This product B is more profitable. Right? If they ask the proof, then how to show the proof? Sometimes they'll ask the proof in the examination. If I exclusively produce the product A, how much product profit I'll get? If I exclusively produce the product B, how much profit I'll get? Actually, maximum capacity, how much we have? Maximum capacity we have only 4,800. See, yeah. Maximum capacity we have only 4,800 labor hours. And he's asking us to show the proof also. So, product A, if I produce product A, how many units I can produce? See, total production for the month is given. Here 500 units, here 600 units is given. 500 units and 600 units, but still maximum number of labor hours, how many we have? Maximum number of labor hours, if I exclusively produce product A, what is the situation? If I exclusively produce the product B, what is the situation? I need to see. Maximum number of hours I have 4,800. Independent cases, any one product if I produce, see, I'll check with the product A, I'll check with the product B, which one is giving more contribution, I will try to produce that product only. So maximum I have 4,800 hours here, 4,800 hours here. So number of hours required to produce, required per unit, how much? Here, come back. Here we required 6, here 3. So, 3, sorry, first one 6, 6 hours required, second one 3 hours required. So, how many units I can produce? Total number of units can be produced. Total number of units produced. 4,800 hours I have total. One unit requires 6 hours. Means 4,800 divided by 6 is nothing but 800 units I am able to produce if I exclusively produce product A. If I exclusively produce product B, how many units I will produce? 4,800 hours I have and one unit requires 3 hours. So 4,800 divided by 3 is, that is nothing but 1,600 units I will be producing it. Yes, is the point clear? Now, next part, that is give proof in support of your answer. For this proof, we will show statement of cost and profit. Statement of cost and profit, that is the first one product A, first one, second one product B, if I exclusively produce product A, what is the profit I'm going to get? If I am exclusively producing product B, what is the profit I'm going to get? So material, what is the material I'm going to incur? See, first I will write the number of units I'm going to manufacture. Number of units I'm going to manufacture. Yeah, 800 and 1600. 800 units and 1600 units. Material cost, multiply 1 by 1. 5 rupees into 800, that is 4000 rupees. 3 rupees into 800, 3 into 800, 2400. That is the labor cost, 2400. And variable overhead, 1.5 into 800, 1.5 into 800, that is 1200 rupees. Coming to the second portion, 5 rupees into 1600, 5 rupees into 1600, that is 8000. 1.5 into 1600, 2400. 1.5 into 1600, that is again 2400. So this is a variable cost. So we will say marginal cost. Total variable cost is nothing but marginal cost. We can say marginal cost is how much? 4000 plus 2400 plus 1200, that is 7600 for the product A. 8000 plus 2400 plus 2400 for the product B, that is 12800. From this you need to remove the fixed cost. Okay, you need to add the fixed cost so that you will get the total cost. Fixed cost, what is a fixed cost? See, come back to the question. See, in the question, I'll zoom in. In the question is said clearly, fixed cost is 50% of the labor charges. See, here 3 rupees was a fixed cost. From that, 1.5 was a labor fixed. 1.5 was a fixed cost. So you check here, what is the labor cost here in this 50%? 50% of labor cost. So 2400 into 50% is 1200. 2400 into 50% is 1200. So this is a variable fixed cost. This is a fixed cost. This is a variable cost. So totally you can say total cost is 7600 plus 1200 is 8800. 12800 plus 1200, that is 14000, is a fixed total cost. What is the selling price? What is the selling price? Sale price is 1 unit we are selling at 14 rupees and 11 rupees respectively. Selling price 14 rupees and 11 rupees into number of units. Now for your understanding, I am writing a few steps extra. 14 rupees into 800, 14 rupees into 800, that is 11,020 rupees is the total selling price. Total selling price. And 11 rupees into 1600, 11 rupees into 1600, 17,600 is the selling price. So we know selling price minus total cost is a profit element. Profit element, 11,200 minus 8,800, that is 2,400 is a profit. And 17,600 minus 14,000, 3,600 is a profit. So if I exclusively produce the product A and exclusively produce the product B, this is a profit status. So obviously the product which is giving me more profit will be produced in the manufacturing unit, right? So this is a first question. So next question, we will see one more question from the make or buy decision. In the sense, I'll give you some introduction about the make or buy decision. Take the example, if you manufacture in your organization or in your industry, what is the variable cost you are incurring to produce that product? If variable cost is greater than the, if variable cost is higher than your buying rate in the sense, what example I'll tell you. If you produce a product, variable cost you are incurring 5 rupees per unit, but whereas if you are able to purchase from the market at 4 rupees, this is for the making you are incurring 5 rupees, and if you purchase from the market, if you are getting from the market at 4.5, then obviously you will buy from the market, right? Because you are getting a cheaper rate from the market. So we need to decide. And if the scenario is in other way, if making price is 2 rupees and buying price is 2.5, obviously we will try to make it. But see, this one anyhow readily available. If you go to the market, you can directly know what is the market prevailing rate for the particular product. But making price is not available. Making price, when it is not available, you need to check, you need to calculate what is the variable portion you are incurring for producing the product. So you need to add all the variable portions. You need to see what is the marginal cost or what is the variable cost you are incurring to produce a product. So if you are incurring less than what is prevailing in the market, then you produce it. If you are getting at the lesser price in the market, then you buy from the market. So that is a decision we need to give based upon the scenario, right? So this is a question. This is also again from the second group. So the question here, I'll read the question. A mobile manufacturing company finds that while its cost 6.25 each to make a product component X, this is a component name, means to make the product, this is the cost they are incurring. The same is available in the market at this price. So market price is this much and making price is this much, with an assumption of continued supply. Okay, sorry, assurance of continued supply. Breakdown of cost is given like this. Material cost is this much, labor, overheads, depreciation and other fixed cost is this much, total cost is this much. Should you make or buy? We need to check whether we should make it or buy it. And what would be your decision if the supplier offers the component at 4.85 rupees each? So we need to check individually. As I told you, first we need to check what is the variable cost you are incurring to produce the product. If your variable cost is lesser than what is the market price, then you can buy, you can manufacture it. If it is higher than the buying price, then you can purchase from the market. So yeah, we will see calculation of the marginal cost in the sense variable cost only. Calculation of marginal cost. What is the cost I am incurring to produce one product? I need to incur the direct material cost 2.75 and direct labor cost 1.75. Overhead, anyhow I have to incur overhead 0.5, and depreciation and fixed asset. Depreciation and other fixed asset. See, depreciation, if I purchase from the external market also, I need to incur the depreciation. If I manufacture in the manufacturing unit also, I need to incur the depreciation. So this is a fixed cost which is not unavoidable. Fixed cost in the sense, this is unavoidable. Depreciation, if you purchase from the external market also, you will incur the depreciation. Because you are using this this asset in your company, you have to incur the depreciation. So this is a fixed cost, this is unavoidable. So when it is a fixed cost and it is unavoidable, you don't take into consideration while taking the decision for make or buy decision. So what is the cost you are incurring? Only variable portion you need to check. 2.75 plus 1.75 plus 0.5 is nothing but 5 rupees you are incurring the cost. This is a marginal cost. I can say variable cost or marginal cost, both are same. Variable cost or the marginal cost. Marginal cost. But the market, but if you buy from the market, the question is saying, as per your calculations, making charges 6.25. But as per if you purchase from the external market, 5.75. But I am saying as a cost accountant, this calculation is wrong. Because why I am saying this is a wrong? Because you have added this 1.25, this is a fixed cost. We have added the fixed cost to the component, which is not required. Anyhow, that is not available if available if you are purchasing from the external market, or if you are purchasing, if you are manufacturing in your own unit, the fixed cost is anyhow unavoidable. So you don't add that fixed cost to the product. So variable cost you are incurring only 5 rupees for the product. So if you manufacture the product in your, or if you manufacture the component in your organization or in your industry, you will incur only 5 rupees. But if you purchase from the external market, you are incurring 5.75. so I can say making price is lower than the buying price. So I will say option one, make it only, because making price is lower than the market price. So it is recommended to manufacture in the in-house. Yes, manufacture in in-house manufacturing is recommended. Then next one, what should be your decision if the suppliers have offers component of 4.85? Now the point comes, if the supplier is ready to give at 4.85, if we make, we are incurring 5 rupees, obviously this is lesser than our price. So what I will say here, buy it. Getting my point? Right. This question you may get for 4 marks, 5 marks, something like that. Next one. Next question we will see. Diversification of production. Diversification of the production. From this also we will see one question. What is the question saying here? From the following data are available in respect of the product A manufactured by the Pankaj Limited. What he is saying, sales price is this much, direct material, direct wages, overheads and fixed cost. The company now proposes to introduce a new product so that the sales may be increased by 50,000 rupees and there will be no increase in the fixed cost, and estimated variable cost are as given below. Advise whether the product B will be profitable or not. Yeah, you need to know one thing. There is a Pankaj Limited. The Pankaj Limited is manufacturing as of now only product A. It is manufacturing only product A. This product A is manufacturing, it is running smoothly only. From this, it is recovered all the fixed cost and it has got additional offer to produce the product B. If the product B is produced, then there will be a sale volume, sale amount will increase by 50,000 rupees and with no additional fixed cost. It means you need to incur only the variable portion. Sales minus variable portion will be your profit. So now we need to check, by adopting this by accepting this product B, can the management or can the company be profitable or not? We need to see. So we will see the question. Here, one by one we will see. First one we will see, take product A. Wait a second. We have product A and we have a plan to take the product B. Selling price is how much? Only product A. If I am producing only product A, the selling price is 250,000 a year. Direct material, from this you remove the variable portion. Direct material 1 lakh rupee, Direct wages 50,000. Direct overhead 25,000. Direct overhead 25,000. So you will get what? Contribution. Contribution from this you remove the fixed cost. What is the contribution you are getting? 1 lakh plus 50,000 plus 25,000 minus 2,50,000. That is nothing but 75,000 rupees as a contribution you are getting. From this you remove the fixed cost. The fixed cost element is 50,000. So 50,000 is the fixed cost. If you remove, you are getting 25,000 as a profit. As of now, you are in the existing policy. You are producing only one product, that is product A. But as you got the offer to produce the product B with no additional cost, so with this you are able to get 50,000 increase in the sales value. So 50,000 only your extra sales you are getting. And the variable portion is, it is given here. Direct material is 24,000 and direct wages 11,000 and overheads 7,000. Is said clearly no fixed cost additionally. So how much you are getting? 24,000 plus 11,000 plus 7,000 minus 50,000 is nothing but 8,000 rupees is the profit you are getting. The contribution, and no additional fixed cost. So you can say that is 8,000 rupees as a total fixed cost. So when I ask you what is the profit you are getting ultimately, in the sense 25,000 plus 38,000 is nothing but 33,000 is the profit you are getting ultimately. By accepting the product B, your profit is getting increased by 8,000 rupees. So it is advisable to undertake the production of product B. Yes, because it is contributing 8,000 rupees towards the profit and there is no additional fixed cost. Yes, understood? Right. Next question, we will do one problem on the fixation of selling price. Again, this is also for the second group people. Here, I am choosing the second question, this one. The second question. I'll read the question. The question here is, a company manufactures scooters and sells it at 3,000 rupees each. Okay, it is manufacturing and selling at 3,000 rupees. An increase of 17% in the cost of material and of 20% of labor in cost is anticipated. This problem, I can tell you, this is an important problem, guys. You spend time on it, you will get this question for the 8 marks. I will do bit slowly. A company manufactures scooters and sells it at 3,000 rupees. So selling price of the scooter is 3,000 rupees, right? An increase in this increase of 17% cost of material and 20% of labor cost is anticipated. So there is an increase of cost. When I'm saying increase of cost, there are two components. One is the material is getting increased. Material is getting increased by 17%, upper arrow by 17%, and labor is 20%. Anticipated. The increased cost in relation to the present sales price would cause 25% decrease in the amount of present gross profit per unit. See, we know one thing, cost plus profit is equal to 100. Here, presently, let's assume we are getting the 100% profit, but as there is an increase in the cost, it will lead to, see, here you try to understand the wording here, it will lead to, see, increased cost in relation to the present sales price would cause to 25% decrease in the amount of present gross profit per unit. See, whatever the gross profit per unit you are getting, that will be reduced by 25%. It means, what can I say? Can I say like this? Previously, whatever the profit you were getting, into 75% only you're getting. Then how come you can say like this? I'll tell you. Here I said cost plus profit equal to 100. I said you take the example cost as a X and profit as a Y. So we can say cost plus profit equal to 100. So cost is a some amount we have incurred and profit is some amount. Cost plus profit equal to selling price. That is what we are selling it the product. But here it is saying because of the increase in the production cost, because of the increase in the production cost, our profit will be reduced by 25%. See here, would cost at a decrease of 25%. In the sense, I can say the profit element is Y as it is into 75%, because 25% is decreased. In the sense, Y into 75%, or else you can write like this, 0.75 Y percentage of Y. Here it was 100%, now it is only 7.5%. The question is not yet completed. I am making you understand each and every point so that you will not miss anything in the examination. Right. See, next, at present, the material cost is 50%, wage cost is 20%, and overhead is 30% of cost of sales. See, you need to remember this one. This is not on the sales, cost of sales. Cost of sales in the sense was this one, X. X is the cost of sale, under which 50% belongs to the material, 20% belongs to the wages, 30% belongs to the overheads. So how to write this one? You assume you have already taken X as a cost. So 50%, 0.5% into X, total cost of this one, total cost into 50% belongs to the material, 0.2 of your cost of production X is your wages, 0.3 into X is a overheads. So your cost is coming to how much? Your cost is coming to obviously 100% only, because 50 20 30, 100% is the cost at present situation. At present situation, X is the cost at present situation, at present. But after increasing the cost of material and labor, and he said nothing about the material cost is increased, labor cost is increased, but he said nothing about the variable cost information. So you take variable overhead as it is X only, that is 0.3X. how to write this one, I'll show you. See here, everyone pay attention. 0.5 material, anyhow it is written, right? Material, I said 0.5X plus there is a hike of 17% into 1 plus 17%. You directly do it. And the next one, 0.2X into 20% hike. 1 plus 20% hike. And overheads, 0.3 into X, nothing hike. So how much you will get? 0.5 into 1 plus 7% is 0.585. I'll write directly 0.240X, and the next one 0.300X. So it is coming to 1.125X. See, this is a cost, this is also a cost after increasing the cost. This one, this is a cost before increasing, or at the present one, this is after increasing. And here also we know cost plus profit equal to sale price. Cost plus profit equal to selling price. See, cost is after increasing is how much? This is the cost, 1.125X, plus profit is how much? 0.75 of percentage of, this is also percentage of Y, equal to selling price. How much is he said anywhere there is a selling price increasing? No, right? What is asked? He asked us to find out. You are required to find out, prepare a statement of profit and loss loss per unit at present. What is the profit or loss per unit at present? Okay, we will find out. We will find out what is the profit or loss for the per unit. And the next one, compute the new selling price to produce the same percentage of profit on profit to cost to sales. What is the selling price? What is the selling price? If I use the same percentage of profit to cost of sales as before. See, as before is this one. See, previously what was your cost of sales to profit? What was the percentage? You need to maintain the same percentage here also. How? I'll show you. First, this is the equation number one. Cost plus profit equal to sale. Cost we assumed X and Y is the profit, and this is a one. And the next one, after increasing the material cost and all, this is a cost, this is a profit, and there is no possibility of And the next one is selling price is this much. So this is a in equation two. So solving equation 1 and 2. X plus Y equal to 3000, and next one, 1.125 X plus 0.75 Y, don't write percentages, equal to 3000 rupees. So you do one thing. You do this one like this, y equal to 3000 minus x. You substitute 3000 minus y equal 3000 minus x is equal to y. So in place of x, you write x as it is, plus in place of y 3000 minus x equal to 3000 rupees. Here 1.125x plus 0.75 into 3000, that is 2250 minus 0.75x equal to 3000. So here x 1.125 minus 0.75, that is 0.375 equal to, you take this one this side, so you will get a 750 divided by 3.75, you will get x equal to 2000 rupees. So in the present situation, x value you are incurring 2000 rupees. So if I ask you, what is the question they asked? Prepare a statement of profit or loss account. Now we are coming to the first answer. This is all for your working, means you have to do it. But the main answer they asked in the question is this one. What is the first question? Prepare a statement of profit or loss per unit at present. See, the selling price present, at present how much? Sale price is 3000 rupees. That's what it is given in the question somewhere. Yeah, this sir. It is given. And material cost we got 2000 rupees. Material we assumed as X. So not material, cost, total cost, complete cost. Cost we got 2000 rupees. In the sense, profit is how much? Cost, complete cost. Don't take this is a variable cost or fixed cost, total cost. So 1000 rupees is a profit. So he said one point here. What is the point he said? See, second point, I'll read it. Compute the new selling price to produce the same percentage of profit or loss to cost of sales before. Cost of sales. See, percentage of profit. How to write percentage of profit? See, I am getting profit is 1000 rupees as a profit. See, you try to understand this point once again. Compute the new selling price to produce the same percentage of profit to what? To cost of sales is this one, 2000. So 2000 rupees. So what is the percentage you are getting? 50%. So if you expect the same 50% profit to the cost of sales, next after increasing the material cost and labor cost, what will be the selling price? That's what we need to check it. So this is the first question. First question answer is this one. Second question answer is second bit. Compute the new selling price. New selling price, how to find out new selling price? New selling price, the cost is how much? Cost is, see, we have seen cost after increasing this one, 1.125 into x. What is the cost of the x? 2000. So you substitute 1.125 into 2000. This is a cost, 2000 into 1.125, that is nothing but 2250 rupees is the cost. Now you need to add profit element to this. What is the profit element? Is said profit element is 50% to the cost of the sales. Cost of the sale is this much. So 50% of cost of sales or cost of goods sold. So I can say 2500 into 50% is 1125 rupees is the cost of the sales. So new selling price will be 3375. How much? 2250 plus 1125, that is 3375. Are you getting my point? So this is the new selling price, right? Yeah, this is a question. I hope you understood, guys. I hope you are enjoying. Please share with your friends.